This is Dr. Albert Phineas, log entry number 27. The information contained within is classified at the highest level. Some of the earlier prototypes of the epidermal cover have been stolen. With this new version, people would be able to be casted within an hour. You'd be able to walk in someone else's skin and no one would ever know. Color, texture, shape is irrelevant. You could be any race, creed, or color. With this substance and the correct voice synthesizer, you could literally be anyone you wanted to be.
Hey, wake up.
What is that? It feels waxy.
That does feel like wax.
I don't know.
I remember running away from something. Like,
what time is it?
I feel like really weird right now.
Let's go.
I have something I need to do. I want to put your mother's jewelry in a safe deposit box.
Okay, sure.
I'm going to go get the jewelry now.
What is this crap? What the hell happened?
I'll be back.
Okay, fine.
Hi.
Hi.
Something, I don't know what the hell is going on, something.
You just got back. What did you do with my mom's jewelry?
I just woke up outside. I had stuff all over my face. I have no idea what's going on. I woke up in the woods.
Where did you put my mother's jewelry? You said you were bringing it to a safety deposit box. I'm not losing my mind.
I'm not losing my mind. I think I'm losing my mind. Well, let's look at the camera. Let's look at the camera. This is the security camera from...
There you are. Wait. Wait a minute.
That's not me.
I'm confused. Sure. What's going on? John? John? Come on downstairs. Am I dreaming? Yeah, it's probably a dream.
I've got to stop the wine.
Hey! What are you doing?
What was really weird is she looked just like me. Looked like you?
Well, yeah, I believe it. The person who stole from me looked just like me.
Oh my God.
Same hair, same height.
It happened to me too. Someone came in my house. I have it on video. I have it on my surveillance cameras.
They're calling this guy the Wax Man. I guess he can just look like anybody and steal stuff and take off. And
a Wax Man? What are you people, crazy? There's no such thing as a Wax Man going around impersonating people.
If the Wax Man could be anybody, he could be any one of us. He could be you.
I'm the Wax Man. You got me. A better chance of finding Bigfoot than seeing a wax man.
But seriously, that's why I called the police. They should be here any minute.
Okay, who made the call about a robbery?
Yeah, that was me. somebody came in and stole all my jewelry and left in my car.
Do you have a description?
It was crazy. She looked just like me. Same height, same hair, same everything.
Some kind of an impersonator. They look like us.
Yeah, but wait. It happened to me too.
This isn't the first time.
So you all had something stolen. The person looks exactly like you. So I just arrest all you guys right now, or what?
No, this is true. It's really happening.
Shouldn't have called them.
Yeah.
Useless.
Well, I know.
If I take this back to the station, they're going to just laugh at me. I need, like, a little more substantial evidence.
All right. Well, thank you, officer. Thanks for coming out. We really appreciate it.
I don't know. I don't think he really believes us.
Nope. We're going to have to take matters into our own hands, I think.
IP Adams.
Hello.
Really? You found wax? That gets my blood going a little bit.
Well, the more information, the better. The more I can get from you, the more I can help you. If you need me, IP Adams will be on the case. Call me IPA for short.
Call that guy. He should be here pretty soon.
All right. Oh.
I hope he's more helpful than the cops, because that guy is useless.
Yeah.
How you doing, folks?
Hello.
It's IP Adams. Oh. I took the liberty of doing a little research. I know a guy who knows a little bit of something about this wax man. So I'd like to introduce Dr. Albert E. Phineas. E is for Einstein. Dr. Phineas has some information about this.
So you know something about this wax guy?
Oh yeah, this is real. This is what the product looks like. In 1 hour, after you rub it across your skin, you can make an exact duplicate of whoever it's on. So literally, it could be anybody, anywhere, at any time.
I woke up and I had some of the stuff on me. I don't know if it's the same thing. Do you think it's connected to what you're talking about?
This is exactly the same stuff. We've been searching for this since my formula got stolen. How recently did you find this on you?
A couple of days ago, last week.
Okay, so this is all very interesting, but how are we going to catch the guy?
I called you guys all together. I don't want to scare anybody or anything like that, but there's been some weird things going on around the neighborhood. Rumor going around, it's a possibility. This guy's called the Wax Man. Don't trust anyone. And just be careful.
You wouldn't want us to go look for him, would you?
That would be a bad idea. Most important thing is don't go looking for this guy.
Do you think there really is a wax man?
Something happened to us.
What if we found him?
Are you saying what I think you're saying?
Yeah.
Give me an axe.
Do you guys want to help us find this so-called wax man guy?
Yeah! Let's go!
There he is!
Is that the wax man?
Let's go now!
Come here, boy!
Come on!
We gotta take the mask off and see who he really is.
Who wants to do it?
Who wants to take it?
You do it!
You do it!
Okay guys, let's get out of here. It's kind of creepy.
Let's dip!
I got a new job.
What is it?
It's a secret, and I'm going to make lots of money.
What kind of secret is it?
Only me and one other person knows.
Is this legal?
I don't care.
What are you doing?
What are you doing? Hey, what are you doing?
That's my money.
That's my money!
What's this, the wax man? They're still writing stories about this?
I think it's true.
I don't believe you.
I saw him. Yeah, he had a white mask on.
Oh, white mask. Oh, sure, because he's the only person in the world who has a white mask. They don't have white masks at every store. Just go on along. Go
on. You never believe me with anything, Mom!
My name's Penny Lane. I'm a reporter with the Plymouth News. I'm doing a story on all the local break-ins.
Would you like to come in?
So, what do you do for a living?
Well, I don't know if it's relevant, but I'm a chemist.
You live in this big house all by yourself?
Yeah, I do. I have other houses, too. I like to vacation. Are you a reporter or are you a cop?
I just like to be very thorough.
So, do you live alone?
I'm writing the story, Mr. Peabody, so I ask the questions. Is there anyone in this neighborhood that you think would be suspicious?
So there's a really weird, eccentric lady across the street who's really into candles. And yeah, we all call her Candorella.
Do you mind if I ask you a few questions? Have you heard about any of these strange things going on in the neighborhood?
We saw him.
Saw who?
The wax man. He almost caught him, but he just like disappeared.
And he wears a mask.
We woke up in the field one day.
Yeah, we woke up with wax on our face.
I think he's creating like wax children.
I don't know, but I want you guys to be really careful.
Whoa! Been drinking too much milk. Who are you? Who are you? What are you doing with those coins? Those are mine. I've been collecting these coins my whole life. I read about you in the newspaper. You're that wax boy. How do I know you're not the wax boy? I'm not the wax boy. You're the wax boy. You're crazy. Somebody's crazy in this room and it's not me. I'm not crazy. You're crazy. Hand over the coins, wax boy. Oh, you want to go? Bring it on. I'm ready for you.
Come in.
Hi, I'm Polly Lane, the reporter. You called me.
Come on in. I think the wax man was in my house.
Really? What happened?
I lost track of time, and when I got home, I saw this person running from my house, and it looked just like me.
I'm hearing a lot of that in this neighborhood. Do you have any suspects for this?
That guy in the big house next door, he's kind of weird. And there's always Candorella. I'm sorry.
Can I help you?
I'm Special Agent Anderson from the FBI.
Just need you to answer a few questions.
Have you heard anybody talk about a body double or a wax man?
Doesn't sound familiar.
I've got information that you received a large shipment of candles. Can I ask you why?
I like candles. I've always liked candles. I use them, I sell them, I light them.
Are you saying your entire business is just selling candles?
That's what I'm saying. I sell a lot of candles.
If you see anything suspicious, let me know.
Hi.
Hi, ma'am. I'm Agent Anderson from the FBI. I wanted to know if you've heard anything about these robberies in the neighborhood.
I saw someone come in and take my stuff. I think it was my doppelganger. Looked just like me.
Have you heard about any other neighbors having this experience?
We hired a private detective because it's been happening to all of us.
You've hired a private detective? The FBI is running this investigation. You're going to have to let him go. Excuse me. Agent Anderson? FBI?
FBI? What's going on?
To ask you about the robberies of the neighborhood. Do you know anything about that?
Yeah, so I don't know that we need the FBI getting involved. We hired a guy, a private detective.
What's this private eye's name?
Adams, P.I. Adams.
Hey, Dad, where are you going? If I were going to the zoo.
Hey, that's my car!
So I understand you've been doing some research. Have you come up with anything?
As a matter of fact, I have. I've got some addresses of people that used to work at the lab, and I'll be checking those addresses out.
So the FBI was here. They actually told us not to use you. They said this is their investigation.
Well, that might be all well and good, but once IP Adams is on the case, there's no taking him off it.
Hey,
to help you out.
Did you guys see my car?
The gray BMW, it just went that way. I thought it was you.
He just went by. Let's just hop in my car. Let's go get him.
Yeah.
Yes.
Hey, have you seen a gray BMW go by this way?
Yeah, he just went that way.
Are you up for a good old-fashioned redneck car chase?
Absolutely.
I don't see him anywhere.
Hey, what's going on?
Today? Let me tell you about it. We just had this big, huge car chase out there, and the guy still got away from us. I've never seen driving that impressive in my life. It's crazy. You'd never believe this. This guy can take people's faces and copy them. He's using and stealing people's faces and...
Maybe they were just taking you for a ride.
We could be in danger right now. This person has to be stopped. There's just no way that the world can be safe with this person in it.
Can I help you?
Are you Polly Lane?
Yes.
I'm Special Agent Anderson from the FBI.
Do you want me to step outside?
I understand you're writing a story about some of the robberies that have taken place in the neighborhood. We need you not to publish those stories.
Excuse me?
This is an active FBI investigation. We need to keep those stories out of the press.
Listen, I don't know what's going on here, but I'm writing these stories. You can't tell me not to.
This is bigger than you, and I don't think you have any idea of what you're getting into.
Have a nice day, Mr. Anderson.
Excuse me? Are you a police officer?
Yes, I am.
Are you investigating the Waxman?
How do you know about that?
I think something happened to us. Some of my friends are acting weird. My friend came in and took all my money. But the Waxman would be an adult, right?
How tall is your friend?
About my height.
Hey, we got some great information. Yep. Yeah, there's even a suggestion that this guy may be recruiting children. Maybe expanding the operation. I think we're really closing in now. I think I'm gonna get this guy.
What's going on here? Hey, buddy! This is no parking zone, man! What are you, dumb? Hey, let's go, man! How many times? Get back here! Whoa! What the heck? I think he's dead, man. They don't pay me enough, man. I gotta retire, man.
So what now? We just seem to be striking out all over the place.
I'm gonna check out some leads around the neighborhood, interview some people.
Oh, excuse me.
Excuse me. I'm Detective Adams. Well, I've been checking out this neighborhood, you know, about the robberies.
Oh, I've heard about that. Do you have any leads? Because I'm a little nervous. I live here.
Don't worry, ma'am. You'll be safe. IPA is on the case.
That's reassuring. It was nice to meet you.
Hey! Who are you? I live here. You're the wax man. You don't know what you're talking about. Hey, buddy, you better think about proving to me that you're not the wax man. No. Nobody's gonna buy that. You're the wax man. We got you. You're crazy. Nobody's blaming me. You're the guy. We're gonna find out who you are. It's over. Open up! Detective I.P. Adams.
Someone's been cooking not too recently. You're never gonna get away with it, Waxman.
So, Detective, you thought you could find me. Well, you did.
Tell me why you're doing it. What do you get out of this?
So you gotta steal someone else's skin, because you don't feel comfortable in your own.
What are you gonna do with me, Waxman?
I think I'm gonna close this case. I've done a thorough investigation and figured out that the Waxman is just a myth. Urban legend at best. It's like the Loch Ness Monster or Bigfoot. Doesn't exist. Case closed. You're never gonna get away. You're never gonna get away with the wax man. I know who you are.
So what's the good news? You got this guy, right?
I'm off the case, guys. I think this is where I stop.
So you're just giving up? Just like that? That's it?
I thought you were the best.
I think he's long gone from here. I think we chased him out.
Well, thanks for nothing. That was great.
Unbelievable.
Oh, there.
I had this.
Right, I was at Flynn's.
I saw, you know, yeah. Carrie, I saw, what, Carrie, I'm not supposed to say his name.
I hope this works out, because we can't live like this. This is, you know, all right, you want to say something like that?
1, 2, 3.
Go.
I hope this will work out.
All in unison.
All in unison.
Mom!
No.
Mom. God, he's attacking me.
No.
Just got stolen. Did you see a guy go by here? No.
Hype or something, you know. I may have walked around the area with a trench coat on with the kids.
It's really in. I'm like, weird. The more you do this, the harder it gets.
Right. That's correct. We're narrowing it down.
Hey. Accent.
That's my teacher face.
Yeah, teacher face. See, now that's. I bring this back to the station. They're gonna laugh at me. Something like that.
Okay.
Action.
Say that again.
Say, I'd like to help. I'd like to help you people, but
okay.
This is a crazy story. If
okay.
I go back to the station.
I'm sorry.
Okay. Action. This is.
Exactly the same stuff. Where did you find this?
That was Derek. That was Derek.
It didn't make it any bigger.
All right.
Eccentric lady that lives across the street who really likes to buy and sell candles.
And go.
Well, there's a kind of weird eccentric lady across the street. She's, apparently really into candles, and we call her the Candle Lady.
You almost got through with it.
She's really into candles, and we all call her Candle Lady. Mark's laughing about it.
He almost said it.
Candle Lady.
What are you saying, anyone?
Like,
say,
we can't think of better nicknames. We call her Candle Lady.
Blacksmith.
He likes to drive his car, so we call him Car Guy. Street, who's apparently really into candles.
Stop.
Hello. Stop laughing. Am I getting my...
She just fell. Okay, oh, now she just fell.
Now close it.
But it's not me. I'm here. They're in my car. It's me, but it's just not me.